Good morning, good morning.
Good morning.
How many can say hallelujah this morning?
Hallelujah.
How many can say there's nothing more powerful than unity in the body of Christ?
Amen.
How many can say, Lord, I release my rebellious nature.
Yes.
I release everything that would oppose your work. I'm talking about confessions of faith.
Yes, hallelujah.
I'm talking about doing what the word says. Yes. Amen. I want you to just turn with me quickly to your Bibles in Romans 10. How many are ready and excited for Sozo?
Hallelujah. Hey, I'm telling you.
Just turn with me to Romans 10. And we're going to read from verse 8. Romans 10, verse 8. Whoo, shalamarebeke shatase. Everybody got it? Romans 10, verse 8. There we go. So, read it after me. But what does the word say? 1, 2, 3. The word is near you. It is?
In your mouth.
It is where?
In your mouth.
It is where?
In your mouth.
Is the word, is the word Joshua 1, 8 that you are meditating on so that it is in your mouth and in your spirit? Because can you see how when the enemy comes at you, and wants your flesh to rise up as opposed to the spirit just before Sozo.
Yes.
You have to be able to confess with your mouth.
Hallelujah.
The word of the Lord. This is what the word in the scripture is saying, and Paul teaches us here. So, the word is near you, it is in your mouth, and it is in your heart. Can you say today, the word is near me?
The word is near me.
It is in my mouth.
It is in my mouth.
And in my heart.
And in my heart.
That is the message concerning faith that we proclaim.
Yes.
That the word is in me. That it is in my mouth and in my heart.
Yes.
Because if the word isn't in me, I ain't going to change and transform. Amen?
Yes, amen.
Oh, I'm just sharing with you this morning.
Yeah.
Verse 9, 1, 2, 3. If, 1, 2, 3. If you declare with your mouth, I can't hear you, 1, 2, 3. If you declare with your mouth, with what?
Jesus.
With your
mouth.
With your
mouth.
What are you going to do this morning?
Declare with my mouth.
Are you going to be silent?
No.
What are you going to do?
Declare with my mouth.
Hallelujah. If you declare with your mouth,
Jesus
is Lord, and what? Believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. Okay? That's one part of the confession of faith. We've all been saved.
Amen?
That God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. Now, verse 10, underline it in your Bible if it is not underlined, because this is what we mean. When we talk about a confession of faith in the Protestant church, in the Charismatic church, in the Apostolic Prophetic church, in the Pentecostal church, you call it what you like. This is what it is. It's declaring the word of God as a declaration and statement over your life and over the enemy and your thought life.
Yes, amen.
And so verse 10, are you ready?
Yes.
Read it with me. 1, 2, 3. For it is with your heart that you believe and are justified. And it is with your
mouth
that you profess your faith and are saved. So when you are speaking more toxins than the word, you got to say, hey, listen, I need to get the confession of faith into my spirit.
Hallelujah.
It's got to be something that is poured out in my spirit.
Yes.
I've got to know that I must be speaking life and not death.
Yes.
And when your flesh begins to oppose that which is of the spirit, and you're not willing to be submitted to what the spirit is saying, you got to know something's going on with you.
Amen.
It's called deliverance. Yes.
Hallelujah.
It's called deliverance.
Amen.
Say,
amen.
I'm willing to be delivered from whatever the Lord wants me to be delivered from this morning.
Amen,
amen, amen, amen. Come in, come in, come in. Welcome. Yes. Okay, so now I want to just, okay, there it is. Let me just read this to you. So most of the teams got a confession of faith that I asked for us to read out as a declaration, a confession of faith, a declaration, and a statement so that we stand in unity.
Yes.
Amen.
How many received that? Everybody, right?
Yes.
Now let me ask you, did you say it?
Yes.
Did you speak it out?
Amen.
Did it change something inside you?
Yes.
Because do you know that even acknowledging you received it is part of speaking it out?
Yes, amen.
See, when we don't, you know where I'm going, right? Okay, so I'm going to read it, and I'm going to ask you to just repeat it after me. Because we're going to say it as a team this morning, as a church this morning. It's a statement and pledge, as a confession of faith and declaration for all of us, as not just those that are helping on the SOZO teams. I want everyone's attention right now. Not just those that are helping on the SOZO teams, but for DGFC as the HQ, the headquarters of the DGAN network. This is where I have birthed this network out of. It is part and parcel of the birthing process of DGFC. They are not separate, even if they may become separate entities, they are one. The first thing I said is, I'm so thankful for all of you. On some groups, I had said, I am praying for you. Yes. Did anybody receive that? Hallelujah. Would you mind letting me know when you do?
Amen.
Amen. Because a prayer for you means a lot. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Thank you. And this is what we received. It is so awesome to be part of what God's house is, to be part of God's house and be part of this life-changing conference together. I want to share this with you, and I want to speak this pledge and confession of faith, all of us, to speak it out aloud. This is our pledge for SOZO 2019, for all of us that are serving, and every one of us, no matter where you're coming from, no matter whether you're on an official team or not, you are serving.
Yes.
Because you're serving the Lord in some capacity, whether you're worshiping, whether you're saying hello, whether you're showing someone where the toilets are, whether you are talking to somebody, you're serving Christ.
Yes.
We're all the hands and feet. Amen.
Amen.
And especially my teams. Right, I want us to say this together. Speak this confession of faith and pledge out loud. The confession of faith is the declaration of speaking the word because it's coming out of our hearts. If this is not coming out of your heart, don't say it. So, repeat this after me. When our heart is aligned.
When our heart is aligned.
In intimacy with Jesus.
In intimacy with Jesus.
Our attitude of heart.
Our attitude of heart.
Will reveal the heart of God.
Will reveal the heart
to others.
God, to others.
And to those we are serving.
To those we are serving.
In and through our ministry areas.
In and through our ministry
Thank
areas.
You, Lord.
Thank you.
That you are aligning our hearts with yours.
That you are aligning our hearts.
May we reveal Christ.
May we reveal
to every
Christ.
Person we are serving at SOZO.
Every person we're serving.
We set down.
We set down.
Every aspect of our flesh.
Every aspect of our flesh.
Ego.
Our ego.
Our pride.
Our pride.
Our stubbornness.
Our stubbornness.
Our unhealedness.
Our unhealedness.
And we lay it down before you.
And we lay it down before
we
you.
We declare.
That everything and anything
that would get in the way,
that would get in the way
of showing you,
of showing you
and your love
and your love
and your heart
and your
to
heart
people
to
would be removed in Jesus' name.
In Jesus
we
name.
Submit ourselves to you.
We submit myself to you.
And therefore to those
therefore to
you
those
have placed in you have put in place to guide us.
You have put in place to guide me.
Did you hear that last one? Difficult, right? Not for some. We will speak only good things of others.
Speak good things of others.
As your word teaches we should do.
As your word teaches.
We will not allow gossip.
Will not allow gossip.
Or unwholesome talk.
Or unwholesome talk.
To touch our hearts.
To touch our hearts.
Or to come from our lips.
Or to come from our lips.
We will make right.
We will make right.
Any wrongs.
Any wrongs.
Before SOZO.
So
that our hearts
are cleansed
and aligned
and
contrite before you. And so that we
are in one spirit
and one accord
as
your word teaches us.
We will not bow down
to any of our insecurities which are birthed in our old self.
Or
allow any of us
or
our issues
to
take away from what God is doing in us
and through us.
Instead,
we
choose to serve you, Lord,
with
all our heart
to
build your
kingdom
wherever we are needed,
without
conditions.
May your
light
radiate through
me
as I serve.
I pray that your spirit will remind me of this pledge
whenever and wherever
I am being used for your glory and in your service, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' name. Isn't that awesome? So welcome, everyone. Some of you came in the middle of the confession of faith. We were just speaking out the word of God over our lives. I didn't have time to put in every scripture because otherwise we would have been sitting there with a WhatsApp that was even longer than it took me to write that WhatsApp. But I want to let you know I wrote that under the anointing.
Yes.
When I was busy praying. Some of you got that. Thank you. I want to say to you this morning, God is up to something powerful. And I'm excited about Sozo this year. We've had much opposition. We've had much stuff going on just before Sozo. But I want to tell you something. God is doing something so powerful. I am so, so excited. How about you? I'm so, so excited. I'm so, so excited. How about you this morning? Come on, say, Lord, I've come to worship you this morning. I've come to worship you and I'm excited about what you'll do. So we just said a confession of faith because no matter who you are in an official team or not, we were just saying, let's be servants of the Lord. Let's shine and radiate with the love of God. Let's come in not just for ourselves, or let's put all our issues aside. Let's put all our problems aside. And let's come into Sozo next weekend ready to say, Lord, what can I do for you? That my heart attitude is right and aligned with your purpose, so that everything will flow according to you, not about the eyes, but about the we's that are in team. Amen? Hallelujah, someone.
Hallelujah.
So come on, get healed if you need healing this morning. Get settled in your spirit if you need settling. Make right if you need to make right. Do what you need to do, because half of our problems come from unrepentance. Half of our problems come from keeping things in that we are fearful to release, because if we repent, it shows up something in me. No, no, no. It's not who you are. It's just a part of stuff that needs to come out. If you don't want it to be a part of who you are, let it come out. Don't keep something in that you need to release this morning, because the Lord showed us that this Sozo is going to be unlike anything. We already set the theme weeks ago, and we've now started to see major prophets globally talking about fires that are arising. I showed Prophet my notes with Matthew 3:11, and I saw a prophet that put in something on Friday, a major global prophet, talking about that the Lord's just spoken to them in their prayer time, that there are fires, baptisms of fires that are rising. And I showed Prophet my notes. I said, look at this for Sozo. I said, can you believe it? What we say, fires of awakening. So you got to know that for me to be on point, I need all of you to just rise up and be what you're called to be, to do what you're called to be in the body of Christ. Don't make life difficult for yourself. Just come and say, I'm coming to worship. I'm coming to release. I'm coming to give out. I'm coming, Lord, to just be. And not only to receive, but to give back. Amen? So, Lord, we come into this place this morning ready to receive your fire. Ready to receive the fire of anointing. Ready to receive all that you have for us. Thank you, Lord, for those that come into alignment with your word. Thank you for those that are standing with you. Thank you, Lord, for those that are standing with us. Thank you, mighty God, for the power of your spirit. Thank you, Lord, that it heals, delivers, and restores. And thank you, Lord, that even this morning, under the anointing of the worship, under the sound that is being released, we're coming to release cries of victory. We're coming to release cries of healing. We're coming to release things that have hurt us and broken us down in the past. We're coming into your house to bring revival and restoration and renewal. And we're coming to receive all that you have for us, mighty God. Come on, give the Lord a shout this morning. Whoa. How many of you have registered for Sozo? Hallelujah, most of you. Come on, we can't wait to see you in the house. If you're a last minute and you still want to come speak to Pastor Brand, there is some room, and we absolutely will make room for you if you still want to come. But I want to say this to you. We are entering the 2020 windows. We enter 5780, the year 5780. Shoraba karabas, shakarabas, sanda, shanda. And God is going to do something of a great magnitude for those that are in it. For those that are in it. And I tell you something, those that are in it are those that are going to get it. Those that are in it are those that are going to receive it. God has got something so amazing for you. I tell you what, we are going to have a bumper sozo.
Okay.
So Lord, come, let your Holy Spirit flow. Prophet, do you want to just lead us in prayer?
Lord God, we thank you, Jesus, that your name will be glorified. Your name and your name only, Jesus. Your name and your name only, Jesus. Your name and your name only. We align this morning, Lord God, with your word, with the spoken word, Lord God. We align with that word, Lord God, and we pray that it pierces and penetrates, Lord God, even the dark places, Lord God, even the hardness of heart, Lord God. We thank you that you will pierce and penetrate every area of our hearts, Lord God, to set us free, to set us free, that we may worship you in spirit and in truth. Woo, Jesus.
Come up to the front. Get ready at the altar. Come and stand and dance before the Lord. Come on, some of you. Come on, come on. Come on, come dance.
To your throne room we go. Oh, da 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 da. Exalt thee, I exalt thee, I exalt thee, oh Lord, I exalt.
things, and to you all things, you deserve the glory.
Come on, you're worthy, Lord.
You are worthy of the Lord.
My King is worthy.
Worthy of the Lord,
exalted, lifted high.
For from you are all things, and to you are all things. You deserve the glory.
You are worthy, come on, church.
You are worthy of the Lord,
so very worthy.
Rise to you, my King, day and night, night and day, deliverance and surprise. Day and night, night and day, deliverance and surprise. You are worthy of the Lord,
in my mom.
You are worthy of the Lord. Of the glory,
day and night, night and day.
Day and night, night and day, little sense arise. Day and night, night and day.
Come on, church, worship this morning.
You are worthy of the Lord. You're so worthy, Lord. For from you are all things, and to you are all things. You deserve the glory. I exalt you, Lord. I exalt you.
Most High, we adore, we adore.
all things. You deserve the glory. Worthy, you are worthy of it all. You are worthy of it all. From you are all things, and to you are all things. You deserve the glory. I exalt you. I exalt you. I exalt you. Oh Lord, I exalt. Right now, every knee will bow. Come on, church,
We need a change right now. Every knee will bow. We need a change right now. Every knee will bow. We need a change right now. Every knee will bow.
We need a change.
We need a change right now. Every knee will bow.
Come on, church.
We need a change right now. Every knee will bow. This is the sound of revival breaking now. Heaven is here to change our everything. You put a new song in my mouth. I will praise you, I will shout. You put a new song in my mouth. I will praise you, I will shout. You put a new song in my mouth. I will praise you, I will shout. You put a new song in my mouth. I will praise you, I will shout. And this is the sound of revival breaking out. Hell, Lord, is here to change our everything. You put a new song in my mouth. I will praise you, I will shout. You put a new song in my mouth. I will praise you, I will shout. You put a new song in my mouth. I will praise you, I will shout. You put a new song in my mouth. I will praise you, I will shout. This is the sound.
Hallelujah, come on.
It's new era, let it begin. It's untold favor, we're walking in. Your word was spoken, and we believe. You pour out blessing, we receive it in love. It's a new day, we're on top of the world.
We're on top of the world.
And oh, it's a new sound that we're singing out. Everybody celebrate, 'cause we're living in the greatest days. And lifting up the highest praise, 'cause you're worthy.
Yes, you're worthy.
You're worthy.
Yes, you're worthy.
And whoa, oh, oh, whoa.
Whoa, oh, whoa,
whoa. Whoa, oh, oh, whoa.
Whoa, oh, whoa.
Whoa, oh, oh, whoa.
Whoa, oh,
whoa. Whoa, oh, whoa. We're dreaming bigger, we're stretching out. Our faith is rising, the future now. We're moving forward, no turning back. Your plan unfolding, we receive it and all. It's a new day, we're on top of the world.
Come on, church.
We're on top of the world.
And oh, it's a new sound that we're singing out. Everybody celebrate, 'cause we're living in the greatest days. And lifting up the highest praise, 'cause you're worthy,
you're worthy,
you're worthy. A blessing that we can't contain, and there are miracles we can't explain. Dancing in this joy again, 'cause you're worthy,
you're worthy,
you're worthy.
Everybody,
everybody celebrate, 'cause we're living in the greatest days. We're lifting up the highest praise, 'cause
you're worthy,
you're worthy,
worthy.
A blessing that we can't contain, and there are miracles we can't explain. Dancing in this joy again, 'cause
you're worthy,
you're worthy. Yes, yes, Lord, we agree that yes, yes, it's in your heart to bless, bless. Lord, we receive it.
Come on, church, this morning.
And yes, yes, Lord, we agree that yes, yes, it's in your heart to bless, bless. Lord, we receive it.
Come on, lift up your hands this morning.
And yes, yes. Lord, we release it, yes, yes. All of your people, bless, bless. Lord, we believe it. Everybody celebrate. Come on now. Cause we're living in the greatest days. We're lifting up the highest praise. Cause you're worthy.
You're worthy.
You're worthy.
You're worthy.
Blessing that we can't contain. And there are miracles we can't explain. Dancing in the joy again. Cause you're worthy.
You're worthy.
You're worthy. Everybody. Everybody celebrate. Cause we're living in the greatest days. And lifting up the highest praise. Cause
you're worthy.
You're worthy.
You're worthy.
A blessing that we can't contain. And there are miracles we can't explain. We're dancing in the joy again. Cause
you're worthy.
You're worthy. Whoa, oh, whoa,
whoa,
oh,
whoa,
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 whoa, whoa,
whoa,
whoa, whoa,
whoa, whoa,
whoa, whoa, whoa, hallelujah, Jesus. Come on, keep your hands together. Usugu, Olusha, Yenkosi. Ilutando Usugu Olusha Ingosi Ilutando. My heart awakes, a new day calling. Calling me, I see the light of mercy dawning, drawing me in. I feel the warmth of your glory on my skin. I feel your glory breaking, breaking in. It's a new day, it's a new start. I see you now, my God is love. Oh, oh, oh. I lift my head to see glory surrounding me. Whoa, cling wide my heart. Usugu, Olusha, Yenkosi, Ilutando. Usugu, Olusha, Yenkosi, Ilutando. Hope light a flame within my soul. Awaken me. Praise breathes new life inside my bones. And breathe in me again. I see the hope of your glory pressing in. I feel your glory breaking, breaking in. Lift my head to see glory surrounding me. Oh, oh, oh. Cling wide my heart. Oh, oh, oh. I lift my head to see glory surrounding me. Oh, oh, oh. Cling wide my heart. Usugu, Olusha. Ingosi, Ilutando, Usugu, Olusha, Ingosi, Ilutando, Usugu, Olusha, Ingosi, Ilutando, Usugu, Olusha, Ingosi, Ilutando. You breathe in life. You break in chains, you own the day, and you said it's a new day. Ignite my heart, renew my flame, revive these bones for your babe. It's a new day, it's a new start. I see you now, my God is love. It's a new day, it's a new start. I see you now, my God is love. Oh, oh, oh.
Whoa, whoa. I lift my head to see glory surrounding me. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Fling wide my heart. Whoa, whoa, whoa. I lift my head to see glory surrounding me. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Fling wide my heart. Usugu, olusha, ingosi, ilutando. Usugu, olusha, ingosi, ilutando. Usugu, olusha, ingosi, ilutando. It's a new day, it's a new start. I see you now. My God is love.
Hallelujah, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. We worship you this morning, Lord. Oh, Rebakashorobo. We worship you, Jesus. Oh, you're worthy, Lord. Oh, you're worthy, Jesus. You're worthy, Jesus. Oh, we worship you, Lord. Oh, lift your hands this morning to the King of Kings. Oh, to the Lord of Lords.
This is the realm of your glory. This is the realm of your grace. I can feel your mighty power. It is moving in this place. La da da, 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 la da da. And in the presence of angels, with God's glory on their wings. Like the voice of many warriors, I can hear the angels sing, singing holy, holy, holy,
sing holy.
La-da-da, 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 la-da-da. This is the realm of your glory. This is the realm of your grace. I can feel your mighty power. It is moving in this place. And in the presence of angels, with God's glory on their wings, like the voice of many warriors, I can hear the angels sing, singing holy, holy.
Worthy, worthy.
Self-conscious, we're dwelling on self, but let's remove the self and just continue to worship. Our worship to be about you this morning. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We worship you. We worship you, Lord. This is what it's all about. We're here because of you. We're here because of you. We worship you. We worship you. We just give you glory.
Yeah.
lovely.
Doesn't matter what it looks like this morning, just worship. Oh, just move into those inner courts this morning. The Spirit is here. Oh, the Lord is here. Solomon Deshe. Presence, Lord, because it's in your presence we are changed. Oh, we welcome you, Jesus. We welcome you, Holy Spirit. Oh, Shalameh. Confession of your mouth this morning. Oh, Ramashenda Kabase. He commands the storm. No matter what's going on inside of you, lay it before him this morning. that Jesus is his name. Jesus.
Jesus. Jesus.
Say his name.
Jesus. Jesus. Jesus.
In that name, there's victory in that name, there's freedom in that name. The wiles of the world come and they make our hearts hard, but this morning the Spirit is here, and where the Spirit is, there is freedom. And the Lord is doing a softening of hearts in every part of this room this morning. The wiles of the enemy came at you, and they put things around your heart. But the Lord today has said, I am the one that calms your storm. But some have said, yes, I know it's you, Jesus. But then you have not put your faith in the one who says his name is Jesus and who calms the storm. And this morning the Lord says, lay it down before me. For am I not the one who created you? Am I not the one who can bring breakthrough in your life? But I'm causing you this morning to take steps of faith, to walk toward me. The Lord would say, don't worry about what has come in your way or in your path that has tried to destroy you. For I am the restorer of all things. I am the one who has come in Isaiah 61 to mend the brokenhearted, to restore those who are captive. In Jesus' name. Holy, holy are you. Holy, holy is he. Holy, holy. Jesus is holy. Jesus will calm the storm this morning. Whatever you're going through, just lay it down, lay it down, lay it down. We're so good at picking it up and running with it, but the Lord said, run with my word and run with my truth. Be like the herald. Take the vision at the appointed time and receive it into your spirit and speak it out as your confession of faith. Speak it out this morning. What I have put inside you is going to carry you through the storm, is going to be your strength, is going to fill you, is going to take you to the other side where there is peace. Shundarabakata Sandai. Holy. 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 Jesus, 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 Jesus. There's something happening in this place right now. I'm looking at faces all over this place that are being touched by the power and the presence of God. God is doing something mighty. Oh, just let the Lord do it. God's still busy. Oh, just lift it up. Some of you thought you were finished. Some of you thought you were over the worship, but the Lord said for some of you it's just beginning. Lift your eyes and cast them heavenward this morning. Surrender all to me. Stop fighting that fight within you, but fight the good fight of faith, the Lord would say this morning. Whatever would resist your spirit, lay it down before the Lord. Don't let it get in the way of your worship. Don't let it get in the way this morning of the presence. Just lay it down, whatever it is this morning. God's busy with you. Oh, we worship, we worship. God's taking you to a new level of worship. God's taking you to a new level of intimacy this morning. If you will engage with the Spirit and the presence, God's lifting you higher. God's lifting you higher. Thank you. in the presence of angels. Shila maraba karaba shundo. Come over. Come with me, Pastor Brent. Shalabarabaka. Oh! What can you get? Oh! Keep that on the keyboard. Keep that on the keyboard. Do some variations on that keyboard. God's busy with that sound. Oh! Come down here, Pastor Brent. I need to pray for you. Whoa! Whoa! Woo! I love the spirit. Shalabakata. So just as the Holy Spirit came upon Jesus at his baptism, and he said, "This is my son in whom I am well pleased." The Lord would look at you and would say, "This is my son in whom I am well pleased." And I would say, "Son, more, Lord, more, Lord." The Lord told me to bring my fires of revival anointing oil this morning. It's not Sozo oil. It's from Prophet Chuck Pierce's church, and that I was to anoint you. So I don't know if you, whew, to just turn him sideways in case. Just sideways. There we go. The Lord looked at you one day and said, "Son, your mother, mother, your son." Shakabasanda. Oh! 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 Full immersion. Shundabakata. Woo! Teacher David, just lift your hands up. Hopefully one of them will stay up because they got to preach. Shikaba sandalabasha. I just want to anoint you with this oil. It's the oil of the fires of revival. And again, we know that the oil has no power, just in case there are any religious people in the house. The oil has a significance of the Spirit. That's what it means. The oil itself has no power. It's what it symbolizes, just like the cross symbolizes the death. The piece of wood holds no power, but its meaning does. Shukaba sendaraba. Sundododo, or new oil and fresh oil, is being poured out on you right now. The Lord said, "You will never see things the same way again, for I am anointing you, Shikamasata, into this new era to be prepared and ready and made new." For the prophetic utterances are going to come. Where's Grant? Going to come from you, Shakabasanda. Oh! Come here. The Lord said, "Your mouth has been closed, but yet you have the mouth of a lion." The Lord said, "In this day forth," the Lord said, "I am giving you the grace that I've poured upon your life in a magnitude unseen." But the Lord said, "The lion shall not roar, lest the mouth be open." This morning, the Lord said, "I am opening your mouth so that the lion of Judah shall roar." Wow. It's the prophetic voice the Lord is doing here, right now. So just lift your hands up, everybody in this place. What are you wanting from the Lord this morning? What are you wanting to receive from the Lord? These were my leaders. The reason I've done this is because they need to be anointed and ready, and God is doing something in them before we even lay hands on them this morning. Something powerful is happening to all of you in this place. We're under the anointing of the Most High God right now. Just keep your hands lifted up. Mickey, the Lord said, I set a seal upon your heart. Not just upon your head, I set a seal upon your heart. Never lose it and never let it go. For that seal is your strength and it is your shield upon your life. There's a seal that is set upon your heart. Jesus, we thank you. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Shalabakaba shanda kasho. Shikaba sanda. Thank you, Spirit of God is here. I can see over your faces how the Lord is just touching people all over this place. God will do it. God is God. There's nothing that you have prayed for that the Lord has not heard. Be patient and wait on the Lord and renew your strength. You will run and not grow weary. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. Lord, we just speak that anointing, fresh anointing upon the band, the worship team, both the worship team that's going to be joining us as well, those that are joining us from other churches, we speak and anoint you right now in the Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit, that you're touching people right where they are. Those in the network churches that are coming to play, those in our church, our band that are playing right now, we speak anointing and a fresh release upon you. Eyes to see and hear, that the Spirit will release a sound in each of you, a powerful, mighty sound, for the lion roars through the sound. Mighty God.
So the Lord says, Why does my church struggle? Did I not set a path for freedom? Did I not set you apart for freedom? Did I not set a path for freedom? Why do you struggle, my church? Why do you struggle, my bride? Why do you struggle? Struggle to let go. Struggle to release. I have made a path, says the Lord. See, I poured my Spirit out on the 12, on the 120. See, I took my Spirit from the ends of the earth to the ends of the earth. Did I not bring deliverance? Did I not bring healing? Did I not set people apart? Did I not set you apart? See how I will pour out my glory in this time. You think you know my glory? You think you know my glory, says the Lord. You have not seen this glory. You have not seen this glory. You have not tasted this glory. Though my word says, taste and see that I am good. You have not tasted and seen this glory, says the Lord. But this glory is a glory that will take you. It will take you, it will take you, it will take you. See, the struggle of the past is the struggle of the past. Have I not brought you word about identity in me? For some of you have not heard that word about identity. Some of you have, the word has fallen on deaf ears. But see, in this new season, in this new time, there is a new glory which brings a new identity. It brings a new level of deliverance. For when my son was on the cross and that veil tore in two, it was a pathway for you to draw into the Holy of Holies, to draw into my throne room, to draw into my very presence. See, this new glory will take you deeper than you've ever been before. My glory, says the Lord. My glory, my glory, my glory. Your story is not finished, says the Lord.
For your story is being formed in my glory, says the Lord. Yes, Lord God, for our stories will be formed in the glory. It is in the glory, not outside of the glory, that the power is and the presence of the God of our Lord is. So form your story in the glory this day, says the Lord.
And the Lord says, leave those bags behind. Some of you are carrying these bags with you. Bags of stories. Bags of past hurts. Bags of things that have held you back in so many different seasons. You keep dragging it with you. So the Lord showed me a picture earlier as we were worshiping about us as the believers, as the children of God, standing in a line, and we're carrying these bags which are so heavy. But the Lord is saying those bags need to be left behind. For I'm upgrading your bags to a new bag. I'm upgrading your bags to carry more of my glory. To carry that which you were meant to carry from the beginning of time. Says the Lord.
Get in, says the Lord. Get into what I'm doing, says the Lord. Don't get outside of what I'm doing, says the Lord this day. For I have come to bring you into my presence, not lead you out of my presence, says the Lord. What will you do with that invitation to form my story in my glory, says the Lord? For my story, says the Lord, is your story, says the Lord. For my glory is your glory, says the Lord. Will you not receive it this day, says the Lord?
Teacher David, come.
Rooted, standing firm on the word and in my presence, says the Lord.
So you see, I am the vine, says Jesus. I am the rooted vine. I am the vine of the vine of the foundation. From the beginning of time, I was, I am, and I am to come, says the Lord. I am the vine. I am the vine. I am the vine. Some of you have been clinging to vines that have been vines of strangulation. You need to step into the vine that gives life, that fruit, the new wine.
I am the vine of the divine, says the Lord. If you are not connected to the vine of the divine, says the Lord, you will miss my story, says the Lord. Who are you connected to? Which vine are you connected to? Lord, we want to say today, we want to be connected to the divine glory, the divine power, the divine presence, Lord God. The divine, not just the vine, but the divine, Lord God. Give us revelation of what that means for each one of us, Lord God. Woo! Jesus.
The vine that you are connected to, the vine which you are growing from, will determine the fruit that you bear in your lives, will determine the flowers that people see in your eyes. It determined the strength of what you do in the Lord.
For John 15, I am the true vine, and God, my heavenly parent, is the gardener, and cuts off every branch in me that bears no fruit. While every branch that does bear fruit, God prunes, so that I will be even more fruitful. Oh, you are already clean, the Lord is saying to you, because you're going, Lord, I'm clean. Yes, the Lord says you are already clean because of the word I've spoken to you. But then comes, remain in me as I also remain in you, for no branch can bear fruit by itself. It must remain in the vine.
Oh, Jesus. So the Lord shows me right now that's for some of us, and this is not prophetic, I know this, but some of it's prophetic as well. But there's some of us who are so concerned about what we look on the outside that we do these gym things. And the Lord says, I'm shaping your spirit. I want to shape your spirit. I want to trim off those things in your spirit that have been hindrances from the past. So the Lord says, do not be so consumed by what it looks like on the outside. Let me become the surgeon on the inside. Let me do what needs to be done on the inside. The Lord says, get out of that place of being entangled. Out of that place of being entangled. There's this wishy-washy, almost like, it's the strangulation thing. I don't know what it is. The Lord's shame is like a bubble. And there's Pathos and Jezebel apostle that has been strangling some of us. The Lord says, do not be ashamed today. Do not be ashamed today if that is you, for deliverance is in this place today. For the Lord's glory is here to bring freedom, to bring freedom, to break the stranglehold of the enemy. It has prevented some of you from moving into your destiny, into your future, into the promises. The enemy has subdued some of you, or some of us, for some time. But now is the time, and now is the hour, and now is the deliverance, says the Lord. Now is the time, now is the hour, and now is the deliverance. Now is the time, now is the hour, and now is the deliverance, says the Lord.
Come on. What is on the inside, says the Lord, will come out, says the Lord. So whatever is on the inside must come out, whether it is good or whether it is bad. What is on the inside will come out. So this is a season where we will not be able to, almost I saw Pastor Branny, a web, like a web of masking. What is on the inside must come out. Whether it's good or bad, Lord God, we bring it to the altar and we say, Lord, whatever is inside must come out, Lord God.
And let me explain that now as an apostle. I'll explain what that is. The greater the glory that falls upon the house of the Lord, the more those things that shouldn't be there are exposed. Because in the presence, no darkness can withstand the light of God's glory. The Lord's cleaning up, and how many can say amen? God's got to do it with us. First, God's been doing it with all of us here in the leadership team. And now we want to just say, Lord, whatever the oil runs down, we must be ready as those that are here, ready to receive. I thought that that was part of an altar call you were about to do, Pastor Bran.
Sure. So, Apostle, the Lord says to me, God is raising up prophets in this hour. For the Lord is setting the church in the right direction. God is sending the church in the right direction. The voice of the prophet is rising up in this time. For I have imparted my spirit to the prophet, says the Lord. I have imparted my spirit to the prophet. Prophet Marietjie. The Lord says to remind you in the order of Melchizedek. In the order of Melchizedek, you have been anointed. You have been anointed. You have been appointed. So the Lord says, come into me deeper. Come into my presence deeper, says the Lord. Come into the throne room deeper. For there is wisdom. There is wisdom. There is wisdom that I will reveal to you, says the Lord. There are pictures. There are things that I will reveal to you. And as you begin to release those pictures, you will see things manifesting. We know the word in Romans 4:17 says that you speak a thing as if it isn't. But you will begin to see these pictures, and as you speak them out, they will begin to form in front of your very eyes, says the Lord. Okay, the Lord says there is healing in this place right now. There is healing in this place right now. The enemy has afflicted your bodies. For some of you, your bodies have been afflicted day after day. And you've had a level of faith that has risen up. But the Lord says, now today is the time where I'll begin to heal you even more. As you step out in faith this morning, watch as my spirit begins to touch you and begins to deliver you from those things that held you back. Shaman, come here. Come here. Sorry, I'm pulling out my name. The Lord showed me your face earlier. And you have problems with your back. We know this. Oh, the Lord showed me this 2 weeks ago. So the Lord says, I will heal you. I will heal you as your faith rises up and as you begin to release those things in your life. As you begin to release those things in your life, watch as I bring you healing. Watch as I bring you deliverance.
So now release the things. Release the things. Release the things that you thought you could never let go of because they keep coming at you in a circle, in a cycle. And you're saying, Lord, how come I don't seem to have the strength to release those things in my life, or I release them and then I let them come back? And the Lord says, it doesn't matter how many times they try to come back. No one can steal your identity, and no one can steal who I said you are. You are a child of the Most High God, and you have power and authority in the name of Jesus. The Lord said, I'm calling you to read my word, to declare it and to meditate on it, and then to speak it out of your mouth. As the enemy comes, and he comes even in the night, the Lord said, speak out my word, and he has to flee in Jesus' name.
So I just heard the Lord say blood diseases. So in the name of Jesus, we speak against blood diseases. Illness is born out of a blood disease. And thank you, Lord God, that we can speak the blood of Jesus, Lord God, over our blood. Thank you, Lord God, you will heal this day. Those that have an enduring spirit, Lord God, will see signs, wonders, and miracles come to pass, Lord God, as we release and decree, Lord God, that every blood-borne illness and disease, Lord God, will go in the name of Jesus, for you shall be well, says the Lord. You shall be well.
Okay. So what happened? What's happened to you? How were you before?
Feeling better.
What? How was it? On a scale of 1 to 10, how was the pain?
Jesus. Yes, Lord.
You see, now you know what I tell everybody? You're in the anointing, right? So you got to keep Come on, run over there, Shaman, and run back. Run over there and run back. Woo! Go back. Prophet, you spoke just now. Thank you, Charmaine. Whoa, praise Jesus. You spoke of blood diseases. Whoever that was for, there was a word for some people here this morning. We're in an anointing of miracles, not just for the body, but for the soul. See, so you get, it's easy. We can be brave for the body, but how many are brave for the soul? But look, blood diseases. Anybody here, the moment that prophet said that, anybody here can put up their hand. Anybody else that you want prayer for blood diseases? Anything in your family, hereditary, that's been passed down or that needs to be broken off you, blood diseases. Anybody in this place? Okay, come over, come up, Max, come up. Anybody else?
Also, that forms a psoriasis, right? I don't know a lot about blood, but that's one thing.
Yeah, but you got the word of knowledge, so psoriasis.
Yeah, it manifests that way.
Prophet, this is for you. We're just going to stretch out our hands, team. Come there. Jesus, 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 Jesus,
Jesus. Jesus, Jesus. The blood speaks a better word, Lord God. And we call on that name of Jesus right now. The blood speaks a better word. Oh, I see a fire. I just see blood fire going in and through you in the name of Jesus. And it is burning every blood-borne disease in the name of Jesus. Every blood-borne disease in the name of Jesus being healed right now in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Your whole body, I see, is on fire in the name of Jesus, because the Lord is burning it out in the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. Healed under the blood of Jesus.
I don't want to call people out by name, but I'm doing this because the Lord has told me to do this. Dane, please come to the front. The Lord just showed me your face.
Hey, we're not on live stream, so it's all good. But not to say we won't be, but I'm just saying.
So the Lord has seen you, Dane, in your room. The Lord has seen you crying out. When, Lord, when? When, Lord, when? The Lord says, I've heard that. I've heard that, and I'm making a way for you, my son, says the Lord. A way for you, my son. The Lord says, do not worry about those things that are around you. You know what it is, and I'm not even going to mention. The Lord's showing me stuff here. But the Lord says, do not worry about those things. Do not be consumed by the worry, but be consumed by my presence, says the Lord. For I am making a way for you, my son. Just as there is a desert, there is wilderness in the desert, I am making a way for you, my son, that there will be grass that you will walk upon. There will be new life that you will walk upon. For I have heard your prayers. I have heard your cries, says the Lord. And I set you free right now in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, I set you free. I set you free. You've been leaving God for the impossible. And the Lord says, I will make that possible for you, my son. As you seek my face, as you seek my face, I will make that possible.
Stay here, the Lord is not finished. So the Lord has given you that word many times before, but Pastor Brand doesn't know because it's been what I've spoken over you through the Spirit. But the Lord said, you know what, the flesh, the Spirit is willing, but the flesh is? Yes. So the Lord says, you know what it is that I'm calling you to, but right now lift your hands up, my brother. We say we break every resistance that tries to take a hold of you, that tries to bring back. Because you see, the devil knows the power of your worship. The devil knows the power of your prayer. The devil knows where you are called to be. And he is petrified of what you are going to accomplish in the Spirit. Because the Lord says, you know the things, the deep things of the Spirit. Yes. Lord, do it again. Lift him, Lord, right now and fill him, God, with such a hunger, insatiable hunger. In the secret place, mighty God. Oh, mighty God, in the secret place.
So the Lord says you've been called to be a shield. You've been called to be a shield, but there has been a shield around you, a shield around you. The Lord says, let that shield go and take up the shield that I have put you, put into your hands. For you are called to be a shield, a shield, a shield, a shield. Do not be consumed or worried about those things, says the Lord. In the secret place of my presence. Yes, thank you. The Lord says that secret places are going to become a public place. In your home, a public place in your home. For there are words and things that I want to show you. Scribe them.
So I decree right now, Lord God, that you baptize this man with your fire. Ooh. That the fire of the mighty God comes upon him right now. That's it. That the fire of the mighty God comes upon him. A baptism of fire, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, that's come it. Upon him. A baptism of fire, Lord God, fall upon him in the name of Jesus. That is... God's desire for you.
Thank you, Jesus. Yes. Shurabakata si Amanda. See what David prayed in Psalm 51. He said, create in me a pure heart, O God, and renew in me a steadfast spirit. Restore to me the joy of your salvation. And grant me a willing spirit to sustain me. Open my lips, Lord, and my mouth will declare your praise. See, immediately people say, how could the Lord say David had a heart after God's heart? Because he was quick to repent, he was quick to make right, and he had a contrite heart before the Lord, always. No matter what he did, he was quick to repent, he was quick to make right, and he had a contrite heart before the Lord. Amen? We've got to be like that, church. We've seen ministers commit suicide. We've seen such devastating things in the body of Christ. We've seen men and that have started revivals in the name of the Lord, and they were under the anointing. They had gifts and anointings that were there to start. They were revivalists, not just the God's generals of old, but right here and now. And now we're seeing all this stuff, this impurity and all stuff coming out about these ministers of God. Three committed suicide last year from Spirit-filled ministries, mega churches in the mainstream. Are you with me? We've got to understand that there is an undercurrent of the enemy, the spirit of the enemy is at work, not outside the church, inside the church. And how do we know? Because we are part of that. And we have to release everything in our lives that consumes us, that is part of the flesh, and acknowledge it so we can be released and healed and restored. Even the ministers of God that have fallen. There have been ministers of God that have fallen in the last year. Powerful ministers, revivalists. And it's not the fall, it's how quickly we get up. That's what I've preached to you since day one. Amen? And so we mustn't be mistaken. Don't think because there's a pulpit. And don't think because we stand up here that we are perfect. But one thing is, we must have a contrite spirit always. And a contrite heart. So that God can work with us according to what the Lord wants. Always in our hearts, right? We can't stand on this pulpit otherwise. We may make mistakes, but we've got to know how to get up. And get up quickly and shake the dust off our feet. So God is taking the church, the global church, in a massive swing. A massive thing is happening globally. If you watch and you see and your spirit is right and you're drawing in from the right sources and you have a look around you at the mega churches and what God is teaching throughout the world, you will see this for yourself, that there is a purification coming to the body of Christ. Why? Because of that glory that's just been prophesied. A glory beyond our understanding. Already the glory is supernatural, but this is a glory unseen, unspoken, and unknown. It's a glory that is being manifest in this time. That's why, do you think the Lord's given us this theme of fires of awakening? Because God's about to awaken the spirit. Those that have been sleeping are about to be awakened. The spirit of God has been, the churches, the enemies tried to desecrate the church of the living God, tried to bring accusation. I'm not talking about our church. That's blah, blah, blah history. I'm talking about now in the global church. But God is about to restore all things. And God is bringing a glory that is unprecedented to this earth. And unless we are in alignment with God, unless we are willing to relinquish the things that hold us back, unless we are willing to be honest with ourselves, unless we really want what God has for us, we're going to be left behind. That's what it is. Will God love us any less? No. Will we lose our place in heaven? No. But is that all you want? No, you want your life to be filled with the fullness of God. Nothing must be more important than having the fullness. Nothing must be more important than being in the presence. Nothing must take the place of God in your life, ever. Whatever's taking the place, you want to relinquish that. Because God's doing something on this earth, and unless we're in alignment with what God is doing, we're going to miss it. God's been speaking to our hearts for so long. It's a powerful thing that's about to happen, I know. Pastor Brian?
There is a healing here for arthritis. Arthritis. The Lord showed me arthritis. There is healing here. And the Lord says, stretch out your hand. Prophet, I saw your face. And there's a couple other people here. Arthritis. Come to the front. Don't be shy. Jesus is here. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Arthritis. Arthritis. Stretch out your hand, says the Lord. Stretch out your hand. Stretch out your hand, prophet. Receive. Receive. Receive the healing. Receive the healing. For your frame was meant to be a frame of solid stature. No crippling. No crippling. No crippling. No crippling. Receive. 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 Stretch out your hands. Stretch out your hands. Healing, 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 healing. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. All through your body, all through your body. That thing, that thing, that thing, that thing. The Lord removes it now. All through your body, all through your body. Receive it, receive it. Whew. Sure. Jesus. 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 For the Lord says, Pat, that for you, some of the things have been years and years and years of things that you've been releasing to the Lord. But now we speak deliverance and healing over you from that thing that cripples. Stretch out your hands. The Lord wants your hands to be stretched out. For the Lord said to the crippled person, stretch out your hands. And he was made whole. So the Lord God touch you now, Pat. By the power of the Holy Spirit. Be touched, Apostle. Where's Apostle? Apostle.
Yeah, the Lord says it's time. Everything is in place in your heart, but now the Lord said just release. 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 Release and you shall receive my peace. Touch you now, Spirit of God. We say fire, 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 fire. The breaker anointing come. Sometimes we want physical healing, but the Lord needs to do some healing in our soul. And often that is more important. And then comes the physical healing, right? Shindarabakatasa.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Fire of healing.
Thank you, Jesus.
Fire of healing.
Yes, Lord.
Fire of healing.
Thank you, Jesus.
That's why I don't look Jenny.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Prophet. Prophet. Where's prophet? Sorry, I'm getting confused. Jackets look the same. Prophet. So, Prophet, the Lord says, lay hands on her.
For the joy of the Lord will be your strength. The joy of the Lord will be your strength. The joy of the Lord will be your strength. I pray in your marrow, I pray in your bones, I pray in your ligaments, I pray that the joy of the Lord will be your strength. When pain comes, you will release the joy of the Lord. You will release the joy of the Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
The Lord says it is done, Charmaine. Yes. It is done. It is done. For I'm closing doors in your life that have been open. Some have willingly been opened. And I'm closing doors. Keep those doors closed. Keep those doors closed. I even speak into your sleep. I pray sweet sleep over you. Sweet rest. Freedom from those things that torment. Freedom. Freedom. Freedom.
I had some notes prepped for say a few things, but I just feel the Lord has laid very strongly in my heart right now. I've seen a picture of I don't even know what it's called. It's a life ring. You know those big inflatable rings on the side of boats that get thrown out to people that are drowning? And the Lord is saying, that why are you hanging onto that piece of wood that's floating in the water to keep you up when I'm throwing you a life ring? There are people that are hanging onto that life ring when there's a lifeboat right next to them. And the Lord is saying, why are you hanging on to the life ring when there's a lifeboat? There are people sitting in a lifeboat because they believe, yay, they've been saved, everything's protected, they're in the right places with the Lord. The Lord is saying, but your lifeboat's bobbing on the water. Why is it not going forward? There are people sitting in a lifeboat that's going forward, and it's going forward to who knows where. The one who has saved you has direction and plan for you. But but there are too many of us, and I speak for myself because I felt this very strongly, clinging to what the Lord has done already instead of looking to what the Lord wants to do now. Oh, the Lord saved me from this, so I'm okay now. No, we're not. No, I'm not. I'll never be okay. I'll never be fantastic. I'll never be perfect. But the Lord is saying, let go of your flotsam. Let go of your lifeboat. Let go of this. And let God. I know that's a bit of a cliche, but there are so many of us that are hanging on to things that we need to have let go of. And we believe we've let go, but all we've done is replace that for another thing that's holding us back. We deal with one aspect of our life, get rid of that, and then we latch on to another little thing that's already, it's still in us. We've got to let go again and again and again. The only time we're going to be perfect the way we are meant to be is when we are in heaven worshiping before the throne. The only way that while we are here, the Bible says we need to work out our salvation. That requires us to look into our hearts and admit, Lord, there's something not quite right here. Help me, please. There comes a point where we need to look and say, okay, so that person that irritated me and bumped the back of my heel in the supermarket in 1977, and you're still hanging on to that problem from 1977, how far forward do you think you're going to go? You're not. You're not. I have a couple of, as Pastor Brand says, I get faces in my head as well. You know who you are. There are things that you're holding on to that you need to let go. Your blessing is right here. But what are you going to do to access that blessing? The Lord is now, to use a colloquial term, the Lord's throwing down the gauntlet. There it is. Next step, you.
So, Teacher David, as you were saying, that Lord showed me there's the life raft, but there's a life buoy. And some of us are holding on to the life buoy. You know the thing that gets thrown out into you when you're in the sea and you're trying to, and you know, that loop. I saw it as an O-ring. Did you say that? Okay, sorry. So I saw it as an O-ring, but then Teacher Dave started speaking about the things that we hold on to. And some of us hold on to these things that we think is a security for us. But the Lord showed me, for some of us, we're jumping through this O-ring like it's a hoop. And some of us are getting stuck in that thing. We're getting stuck in that thing. Hallelujah. And it's nothing to do with the weight or how big you are or whatever. But we're getting stuck in that ring when the Lord's saying, how many times do I have to show you that there is a way out? There's a way out. We know what the word says in Corinthians. God will give us a way out from underneath that thing. Hallelujah. Don't hold on to those O-rings anymore. Who is your lifeguard? Oh, Tola, Shita, Bakara, Basundo, Teda, Beshida, my sister. Come here. Come here. Shiti, Abakasuru, Basho, Shura, Kaba. There's no coincidence you're here today, right? No coincidence today. I need to do this.
know that you are loved.
Yes.
Yes.
Not up here, but here. Know that you are loved. And the Lord calls you my delight. You bring a smile to God's dial. You know that. But do you know that?
You're so precious, Tutla. So, so precious. Not just to DGFC, to us, but to the Lord. So, so precious. And from... So the Lord says the deal is sealed. The deal is sealed. Let go of the anxiety and the stress and the worry, for the deal is sealed. And you will know that it is I, says the Lord, who has made this possible. I have the pen, says the Lord. I have the penship, not just of your life, but of the deal. I have the penship. Prophet, do you have something?
Amen. Come on, give the Lord a shout this morning.
Amen.
Give the Lord a shout. Amen. How many can say this morning the Lord has touched you and moved in your heart and your life? You see, it's not that the Lord is always wanting to draw near, but it's how near we let the Lord. Isn't that right? So many things get... What did I say previously? The enemy is a thief of time. You know? And he just wants to steal your time away from the Lord constantly, giving us reason not to be present, not to be in the presence, not to be where we need to be. But today, God has realigned some of our lives, and God has saturated others with a new glory. Others have experienced the fire of God. Others have experienced the healing of God. Some have experienced things in their bodies. Others have experienced things in their spirit, in their being, in a being. Amen. Hallelujah. Give the Lord another shout. Give the Lord another shout. Sozo may be a 2.5-day conference, but it is powerful because of the acceleration which comes by agreement. This is a conference the Lord told me to host years and years and years and years ago. Sorry? You want to come to every session. Every session. God's about to impart some powerful things. That's what we do in an apostolic ministry. We impart. The apostles and the prophets impart. The fivefold come and they pray and they bring healing, reconciliation. Things that you've long ago not been healed from will be. And even if you're serving, doesn't matter where you're serving. You can worship and praise wherever you're serving. I mean, God's going to do it in you. God's going to touch you, because the more I found, the more I serve, the more the Lord's got my back. So when I'm doing God's business, God's got mine. So we want to be about the business of the Spirit of God, about the business of the heavenly parent God. That's what we want to be, right? Amen. So I feel at this point, just before we close, if we can just ask those, I know there's a lot that are still coming from the other churches, but the helpers now, I just want to ask Prophet to pray over. Just come over here and quickly stand in the front. All those that are helping and serving in Sozo, just quickly come up to the front. We're just going to quickly pray a release, not like a da-da-da-da-da, just like a do-do-do-do-do. So whether you're in the band, whether you're in the whatever serving team you're in, just come right now. I'm wondering if you shouldn't stand facing the other way. No, the teams. Because you've got to pray for everyone, right? Yes. We're just going quick. No, we're going quick. We're not wasting time. The Spirit's here. Amen.
Oh, amen.
Spirit is here. Anybody else? Okay, cool. Yeah. Stretch your hands out, church. Let's stretch our hands out as Harabashaka. I'm just coming behind your backs right now.
Ooh, gosh.
Fresh wind, Lord.
Yeah.
Fresh mindset, fresh wind. Spirit presence of God, come. Burama shekaba sanda rabe shondo. Huraba shakaba sendai.
Just
gonna go quick.
Yes. Oh my. I hope we possibly. Pastor Brandon, maybe just behind. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Can we stretch out our hands and really say to the Lord this morning that we intercede and we stand in the gap for these helpers whose hearts need to be ready, whose spirits need to be aligned. So that's what we are declaring and decreeing right now in the name of Jesus. Heart alignment, spirit, spirit, spirit. Lead me where my trust is without borders. In the name of Jesus. Aligned, aligned, aligned in the name of Jesus. Heart aligned in the name of Jesus. Heart aligned in the name of Jesus. Truly surrendered in the name of Jesus. True surrender in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, that this week, Lord God, we will prepare our hearts for you because we serve, Lord. We serve you and we serve others in the name of Jesus.
So the Lord showed me a lasso being tied around each one of you, interwoven, a lasso between each of you, like weaving together. Thank you. Weaving together, the Lord showed me that it's a holy lasso, amen, if I can use that word, woven together, a beautiful tapestry that the Lord will reveal through each one of you as you serve at Sozo this year. Hallelujah. And your heart's cry will be, Lord, I will serve with excellence. Lord, I will serve because it's about the kingdom.
Thank you, Lord, for our spirits are yielded and surrendered to you, Lord God. And then it is yielded and surrendered, Lord, to our overseers. I thank you, Lord God, that we serve, Lord, with a grateful and a thankful heart. And a heart, Lord God, that is so excited about what you are going to do. I thank you that my heart is yielded, Lord God, to serve in whatever way. I thank you, Lord, that I impart that to these helpers right now in the name of Jesus. To serve, Lord God, as you would have us serve in the name of Jesus. Surrendered, surrendered, surrendered. Rendered in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Can we say amen?
Hallelujah.